People across Hennepin County got an unexpected wake-up call this morning.
A siren sounded just after 6 a.m. There was no emergency. It was just a mistake. But that got us wondering, how do tornado sirens work? Good question. John Lauritsen, I understand you heard those sirens bright and early this morning, huh, John?
I sure did, Frank. And admittedly, my first reaction was, I hope this siren doesn't wake up my kids at 6 o'clock in the morning, and I just want to go back to sleep. But the right response would have been to take cover, because false alarm or no false alarm, the people running these sirens want us to take them seriously and to seek shelter. Do you live in Hennepin County?
I do.
Did you hear the siren this morning?
I did.
Live close enough to one of Hennepin County's 242 sirens, and it's almost impossible not to hear them.
When I was young, they used to scare me. They're an eerie sound.
And it makes you wonder who's pushing the button that's grabbing our attention.
Well, hopefully somebody who's smart and who knows what's going on is pulling the trigger on these things.
It's a local decision made, and there's a button that gets pushed in effect, if you will, at that dispatch center at the county level.
Joe Kelly is Minnesota's Director for Homeland Security and Emergency Management. He says in most counties, Hennepin included, the sheriff's office is in charge of sounding the sirens.
Is it computer-based now? Is it somebody just sitting there pushing a button? How does this work?
Well, they are computer-based, and again, as a whole system, they're connected to the telephone system.
Here we go. We're setting off the sirens.
In 2012, Jason DeRussia got a chance to sound the alarm.
This is very exciting.
A ticker from the National Weather Service comes into dispatch, letting them know it's time to trigger the sirens.
And that means it's going?
Yep, it is going.
Hennepin County says since 2012, the system has become even more computerized, and a computer hardware malfunction is to blame for this morning's false alarm.
What's your reaction when that happens?
Not much.
Yeah, you hear it and you wonder what's going on.
False alarm or not, Kelly wants you to take cover when you hear that familiar sound.
So my reaction when that siren was going off, that I hope this doesn't wake up my two-year-old and then I roll back to sleep, was not the right reaction.
That would not be the right reaction. That was wrong.
Sure was. In all seriousness, they worry about complacency with the sirens, people just not paying attention to them, because they're used for more than just severe weather. These were actually installed right after World War II during the fear of the Cold War that we might be invaded at some point. Now they can be used for tornadoes, severe weather, hazmat emergencies, fires, things of that nature, Frank and Amelia. So they can also actually just send off one siren in one town or just one town, whatever it might be. They can work in zones, whatever they need to do.
Good to know, John.
Yeah. Thank you.
Good to see you. If you have a good question for John, email it by going to WCCO.com/links. He's right, Chris.